Good evening. A no-fuss, low-key family funeral, just as the Duke of Edinburgh had wished. Details have now been revealed for how Prince Philip will be laid to rest. One thing is certain, though. COVID-19 restrictions will mean this is unlike any royal funeral that's come before.
They may be in the spotlight, but this is a family nonetheless, and one now in mourning. It was for Prince Charles to reflect on his father's 70 years of devoted service to Queen, family and country.
As you can imagine, my family and I miss my father enormously. He was a much loved and appreciated figure.
A loss and sorrow shared around the world.
My dear papa was a very special person who, I think, above all else, would have been amazed by the reaction and the touching things that have been said about him. And from that point of view, we are, my family, deeply grateful for all that. It will sustain us in this particular loss and at this particularly sad time.
At Windsor Castle, the Queen's youngest son, Prince Edward, and his wife, Sophie, the Countess of Wessex, emotional after spending an hour with Her Majesty. The Duke of Edinburgh's funeral will be held next Saturday, April 17, at 3 p.m. local time in St George's Chapel. It will be a ceremonial, not state funeral, in line with Prince Philip's wishes. Even so, it will be largely scaled back. The Duke will not lie in state. Prince Charles and other members of the family will join in a foot procession as Philip's coffin is transported by a modified Land Rover designed by the Prince himself through the castle grounds to St George's Chapel. In line with COVID-19 restrictions in England, only 30 mourners will be in attendance. The Queen is yet to release the guest list. Prince Harry will attend, Meghan won't, on doctor's orders. A royal funeral like no other. Social distancing will be adhered to and mourners will wear masks.
Very different to what had been originally planned for Prince Philip's funeral, but he was always a no-fuss man. He was always somebody who wanted things played low-key, and in death, he's got his wish.
A sentiment echoed by his cousin, Lord Ivor Mountbatten.
He didn't want any fuss anyway, so he's probably having the last laugh, because I don't think he was really relishing the 100th birthday celebrations.
Outside Windsor Castle, the carpet of flowers grows by the hour. Each bunch a heartfelt mark of respect. Each candle and card a personal message for a mourning queen.
It's just nice to be here and have a quiet moment to reflect on both of them, really. I used to see him in his carriage, just on the four horses going through. He always said, "Good morning, ladies," as we were running through. Yeah. He's just... a lovely man that we're going to miss.
We've been told these tributes are set to be respectfully removed and placed inside the grounds of Windsor Castle for the Queen to appreciate the flowers and messages of support in private.
Group after group found time to pay respects in their own way. Members of the Household Cavalry riding in procession, saluting in unison. Following the Queen's wishes, there will now be 2 weeks of royal mourning instead of the usual one. Symbolic, perhaps, of Prince Philip's place in history, but more importantly, of family's love.
Europe correspondent Carrie-Anne Greenbank is at Windsor Castle for us. Carrie, the guest list is expected to be finalised over the coming days.
Well, it is, Pete. That's right. It's widely expected to be a family affair. Normally, ceremonial funerals like this could attract up to 800 guests. Because only 30 will be invited in line with restrictions, some difficult decisions will need to be made. Boris Johnson has already said he will be forfeiting his seat to allow more family members to attend and to say their goodbyes. Now, the funeral will be entirely private. The public are being discouraged from turning out here to Windsor Castle, but the public will be allowed to participate in one way, and that is at 3 p.m. on Saturday as the funeral starts. There will be a national minute silence held, Pete, for Prince Philip.
OK, Carrie, we'll leave you at Windsor and move to Buckingham Palace now, where we find Europe correspondent Ben Avery. Ben, there could be a permanent tribute to the Prince.
Yes, it's looking very likely that a statue of Prince Philip will be installed here at Buckingham Palace. It's an idea that has the support of both sides of politics, and there are many people saying that they will happily donate to the project, which is expected to cost many millions of dollars. In the meantime, though, there have been a lot of other tributes for Prince Philip, including a spectacular gun salute.
From the Tower of London to Edinburgh Castle and somewhere out at sea, the United Kingdom pausing at midday for a death gun salute, honouring Prince Philip's journey from Navy cadet to the longest serving consort in British history.
Certainly in my lifetime, I'm 66, I haven't known another monarch and or consort, so I think it's pretty sombre.
Among those watching on, Claire Glynn-Rowe from Adelaide.
So sad for his family and for the nation, but yeah, it is such a privilege to be able to witness it firsthand.
London landmarks were adorned with images of the Duke of Edinburgh, and in the English Premier League, respectful silence. It was the kind of fanfare that the Duke didn't want, but the country felt compelled to give.
The gun salute is one of few tributes that can take place under this country's strict COVID-19 lockdown. And to make sure that everyone can feel a part of it, it's being broadcast live into British living rooms.
That is where authorities have asked people to stay, but at Buckingham Palace they've continued to gather, lay flowers and pay their respects.
I brought yellow roses for friendship because I think that's what he exhibited to everyone who came into his world.
His closest confidant posting a tribute from their golden wedding anniversary on Instagram, still true almost 25 years on.
He has quite simply been my strength and stay all these years. And I and his whole family and this and many other countries owe him a debt greater than he would ever claim or we shall ever know.
Life for the family is for the moment on pause. Prince William cancelling his appearance at the British Academy Film Awards, his grandmother and his queen, his priority. In London, Ben Avery, Nine News.